But you know, once you make it to the NBA, it's real now, man. Everybody was their best player on their college teams and high school teams, things like that. And you know, once you finally get to the NBA or make it to the NBA and fulfill your dreams, suddenly it's like everybody's was the best player on their team. So with me, it was a big time adjustment period where I went through the ups and downs in my career where I had to, got drafted by the Bulls and got traded to the Wizards and played with the Knicks and things like that. But it's kind of funny just, how sometimes God takes you through all these things and, he puts you through all these trials and tribulations, the highs and lows that comes with, the basketball and things like that. And for me to finally, find a home in Milwaukee where, it's fun to play basketball, have great teammates. We have a good team, but we also have a beautiful city as well that I love a lot. Definitely made me grow up a lot over the past 2 years with me being there and just all the tons of, fan support that I get, when I play basketball there. It just makes it that much funner for me to, wake up each and every day to go play basketball. It makes it fun for me and off the court as well, man. Just, how genuine everybody is, how passionate, how everybody is for their sports, man. So it's fun with me. It's definitely an honor to, be a guy that's selected to, represent the city. And, I definitely don't take that lightly at all.
Yeah, thank you so much. The video, the concept to have you showcase a day in the life of Bobby Portis in Milwaukee and just interacting with fans and the people was such a fun concept to get behind, and one we knew the fans would embrace. And it seemed like that day in particular, I'm sure you get it all the time, fans just coming up to you. What's it like just going around Milwaukee and getting to interact with such great fans and passionate people who love their city and love you and love the Bucks?
Oh man, it's fun, man. Like I said, man, like in some of the bigger market teams that I played in, like Chicago and New York, man, they love the star player guys. They love, the guys, the box office guys, the guys that selling tickets. They love the big names, big star stardom type guys, man. That's just the truth of it, man. Sometimes the role players on the team or the others on the team kind of go unnoticed. And in Milwaukee, it's not like that, man. They cherish 1 through 15, man. All their guys, they love them all. If anybody goes anywhere, they treat them the same, man. So it's just kind of fun for me to be in that type of environment, be around genuine people who care. Obviously, they want us to win and they hate when we lose and things like that. But, aside from, the wins and losses, there's good genuine people that's from that city, and that's what makes it, one of the funnest parts to play for them, man. It's just, how much fan support you get, how much love you get, not only, at the Fiserv Forum, but even when you go eat and when you even pumping gas at the BP gas station I go to and things like that. It's just always fun to, have that fan support and that fan reaction out of, the guys just from, that city.
You got to go to a couple of locations for the video, and you helped pick out the locations for us. I think places you want to go and experience, and places you've experienced before in Milwaukee. Do you have a favorite? Do you have a favorite memory from the video, or just a favorite spot you like to take your friends and family to in Milwaukee?
Probably the beach. I'll probably go to the beach. My mom actually texted me today when the video dropped on the socials. She said, "Dang, where's that beach at in Milwaukee?" So I guess
That's
that
great.
means she wants me to take over with us. That'll probably be one of my favorite little new spots. I played sand volleyball before, but this time was a little hard. I don't know if because I had socks on, I had a shirt on, or whatever it was, but man, that sand was tough that day.
Yeah, sand is definitely always tough. That's great.
Yeah.
It's awesome that your mom wants to come and experience the beach and check out the site some more as well. And that's exactly what this video is all about. I also love the part where you're giving the kid the coffee at the in the video. Wolfgang gets the shout out from you.
Wolfgang, yes, sir.
That's
That's
fantastic.
also
Well, I
cool though,
know.
man. It's also cool with the kids though, man. Gotta give the kids all the love, man. That's the next generation, man. you just never know, you know what I'm saying? Like nowadays with all the social media things, like you see, you know, guys taking pictures with, you know, their idols and things like that. Then one day they're in the NBA playing against them and next them. So, you know, nowadays, or, you know, you just never know who's going to be who. So you want to treat everybody the same, man.
Yeah, that's wonderful. I know you're got a time crunch here, but I did want to give an opportunity for some of the media on to ask a couple of questions. Would that be all right still to get a couple from the media on the call today?
Yes, sir.
Fantastic. So if any of the media wants to jump in, you can do that, or just drop a quick note in our chat and we can make sure we get a couple of questions asked. Nobody's got any questions? I know I've got a few more, so I'll take the time if nobody else wants to jump in from the media. Well, my follow-up question for you was definitely, we obviously hope you had a great time doing the video. What's the next round of stuff? Where's the next place you want to go in Milwaukee that we can take you to later on this year, or maybe in the winter, and showcase some of the stuff while you're in season? Oh, you're still on mute, Bobby.
Oh man, my bad. I was just talking away too. So, man, honestly, man, probably like one of my favorite things to do all time outside of basketball is bowling, man. I love bowling. So definitely go to a couple bowling spots. I would love to do that for sure. That's one of my top things to do. Me and all my friends, like we don't bet for money and things like that. We bet for push-ups. So I would love to get some fans doing some push-ups on the ground per frame. I think that'd be cool for sure. And then, man, probably just taking my mom to the beach, man, because I know she's going to ask me that again probably here soon. So I would definitely got to take my mom out there to the beach and let her experience their vibe that's out there as well, man. It was definitely a good day, too. It wasn't too hot, too cold. It was just perfect. So hopefully we can get one of those days in here soon in the upcoming weeks before it gets too cold outside.
Yeah, that's right. Well, at least with bowling, we can keep you inside during those winter months too, right? And so always plenty to do, always a lot of fun things to do. One of my other favorite moments from the video was when you were trying the Bloody Mary there at the public market. Are you much of a Bloody Mary drinker usually, or is that one of the first ones for you?
Man, I'm not even gonna lie, man. That was my first one ever. So like I always heard of like the Bloody Marys and things like that, but I'm not even gonna lie, like, I didn't even know like what was in a Bloody Mary for real. But then I always heard it was tomato juice and something else. So I was always kind of turned off by it. But I'm not gonna lie, it was kind of good though, man. It was kind of good. Like we had to chug the beer afterwards though. That was new to me right there. Drink a Bloody Mary and chug a beer. That was all new to me right there. But I guess it's a Wisconsin thing, man. A Milwaukee thing.
That's right. Well, it's so fun to get to introduce you to some of the different Milwaukee cultural touchstones and those things that really help define the city. And it's so great that you're coming back for four more years to hype us on the court and hype us off the court and be that hype man. So it's great to have you part of the Visit Milwaukee team, helping us showcase the city to the world. And love to hear that you're going to be bringing more family in, your mom and other family members, and maybe we can get a whole group tour bus from Arkansas, from the hometown.
Yeah, that'd be cool for sure. Hopefully, man, this year, man, we can get, like, you know what I'm saying, just a bunch of kids together and stuff with my foundation and partner up with some things, man, to help the kids out down there in that area in Milwaukee as well, man. For real. That's one of my big things I want to accomplish, too.
Yeah, so we'd love to work with you in the future, helping with the foundation and like you said, lifting up that next generation of kids in Milwaukee to help them achieve their dreams and find their success, whether it's on a court or in a boardroom or wherever it might be in the future, right? So,
absolutely, man. Highest human act, man, is to inspire, man. So that's all I try to do each and every day, man. Give my wisdom to the next, and, you know, keep a clean slate, low maintenance, man.
That's right. Do you have a, my last question for you, and anybody else who wants to jump in with one more question, just drop it in the chat before we finish up with Bobby's time here. But have you bought a Harley Davidson yet now that you've been to the museum and explored?
Nah, I'm not even going to lie, man. That's like in our deals, man. We can't like ride things like that. So yeah. I'll probably never get on a motorcycle at all. And the one time I did get on a motorcycle, I was like in high school. It was like one like my mom and them had bought us for like Christmas or something. I had slipped on some water and I scraped my chin. I got a big gash up under my chin that I'm gonna have for life. So I learned my lesson at an early age, man. Do not mess with those bikes.
That's right. Well, that's the great thing about the museum is you get to sit on them and have the fun with them without any worry, right? You can go and do
too much power for me, man. Too much power for me.
And you know, the other thing we talked about for Milwaukee was cheese curds. We've got our cheese curd pass and
that was fire. I love those cheese curds.
Yeah,
that was probably like a side of everything, like all the places we went. That was probably my favorite thing I did that day. I ate so many cheese curds in that place. those were good.
That's right. Did you dip them in some ranch too?
Dipped them in the ranch. Absolutely, dipped them in the ranch. It was definitely fire, man. Those was good right there, man. Yeah, not even gonna lie.
I don't see any questions popping up in the chat. I know many of our local media partners joined in today to get some firsthand account from you of what it was like making the video. And we just, again, appreciate you doing that for Visit Milwaukee, for our partners, and for the whole city, just showcasing the things that you love and some of the things you got to experience for the first time as a newer resident and things that you're going to show your visitors, the people that you're going to treat to the city as well. So great that you took the time to do that. And I know you've got a few more media interviews lined up this afternoon as people want to know more about your partnership. So I appreciate you joining us today, and we'll let you get on with it and do the other interviews throughout the course of the day. And just to thank you again from Visit Milwaukee and our partners at Hanson Dodge for all the time you gave to us. And of course, thank you from the city of Milwaukee for all the things you do for us on and off the court.
Thank you, man. Love, man. For real, though. Appreciate it, y'all, man. It's definitely going to be an honor, man. And I'm definitely excited, you know what I'm saying, for these next 4 years, man. Going to be good, man. Hopefully, you know what I'm saying, we can bring some more championships to the city and keep helping the city grow and expand.
Fantastic. All right. Thank you so much. Appreciate your time.
All right, man. Love.
You bet. And thanks to everybody else who joined today, all the media and other partners and staff. Greatly appreciate the time. If you have any additional follow-up questions for Bobby or for Visit Milwaukee, definitely reach out to Claire Canning on our staff, all of our media partners. I know you've got her contact information. So we look forward to continuing on this partnership. And of course, share the video, share all the fun on your social media, and help us to promote Milwaukee. Thank you.
Thanks, Josh, so much. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Max. Appreciate all your help.
Of course.